Today I'll be talking to you about the UPI scams. Nowadays you might be seeing this. This is the latest news today. So a Bangalore techie orders a pizza and he loses 95,000 rupees in an online scam. So what happens is there are many ways in which people are trying to exploit the existing things. Let's understand what are the different things people are doing. One of the very popular thing which I have seen about OLX or OLX scam, probably you would have all heard. What happens in this, whenever you have listed something that you wanted to sell, a bike or a car or probably your mobile phone or whatever it is, they are trying to do one thing is they say that they are very much interested. Now assume that I have a bike I want to sell because I need some urgent money. Now what happens is after you have put an ad, somebody calls you and says that he is very much interested and he wants to pay the money, advance money, without even looking at the product. They say that I want to make an advance payment, I am staying somewhere outside, my brother or my son or somebody is going to come and pick the thing and they will pay the rest of the things. I'll be paying half the money. That's the standard story they say. Now generally what they are trying to do here is, let me show you in Paytm. Now this is this UPI transfer. Go to more. Now you see here, one is to make the payment, another is to request payment. So when you put this request payment, what you are trying to do is, see in this UPI, it's very simple. It's just the phone number at the rate of Paytm. This is the standard thing. Now what happens, I just say I'm just putting 1 rupee, this is my friend, I'm just say, if I just say proceed, now what happens is he will get a message something like this. I just sent my friend this message. Now what happens is he will get a message saying that such and such a person is, or whatever is stored in this particular account name, it's my mother's account, so her name has come and I have requested 1 rupee. Now there is a link. Now generally understand that people don't even look and read everything, especially when there's somebody saying that he's making the payment. They click on this, and when they click on this, now see what happens. When they click on this, this is what they get, saying that this is the payment. Generally, see, with the excitement that somebody, you have just placed an ad and immediately somebody is trying to make a payment, people especially who are very new, they may not even read. And people, even the educated people, because we are very emotional, and when emotional point is, I wanted money urgently and somebody is paying. So if you click on this pay button, now what happens is you are not going to get money. Reverse thing is, money will get debited from your bank account. Understand, this is exactly what is happening, and a lot of people are getting fraud with this. This is one of the method where people are actually trying to scam you. There are many more methods. What happens is they are also using a few other things, like now for example, this techie guy, he had a different kind of thing. Now for him, they have not given the complete details, but hopefully there are few other things which actually cause these kind of fraudulent things. One is, if you have downloaded an app, see, if you download any app, most of the time what happens is it asks for a lot of permission. For example, when I click on the phone pay, what happens is it will ask me few details, like I want access for contacts, I want access for your camera. So there are many things it will ask you permission. Similar to that, there could be an app you have downloaded which actually asked permission, and generally we give permission, like that we have given permission, then they have an opportunity for hacking the phone. Second most powerful thing is many of them, what they do is they create a replica of a website. Like for example, let me show you. Now, let's say I'm just talking about a bank. Like let's say I'm looking at Axis Bank. Axis Bank, let's say personal thing. Okay. Okay, see whether it is any banking application, if you are trying to go to that particular bank account, now what happens is not getting here. Let me okay. Now, for example, any of this banking account, assume that I am looking at this personal banking account. It is okay, I'm not getting it. Okay, the login retail banking. Okay, this is how a retail banking website looks. Now, generally what happens, especially when you get an email, now most of the cases we will not even look at when you look at something like it has come through any bank, we generally don't try to look in detail about who has sent the for example, who has sent the email. Now for example, assume that the notification, some notification comes, say alerts at Axis Bank. Now this is an alert which has come. Now what happens is, assume that you get something, it says a bank name. Now see, this is a subject line. The subject line is this. Anybody can change the subject line and they have their email address. Now in that email they send you that your account is blocked, something which will scare you. They are trying to actually scare you, or they are saying that please change your password. We have observed that there is some transaction which has happened, we want you to authenticate, something like that. Some email comes and they give you a link. And link may be something looking exactly like this, like your any banking account. Now what happens, generally we don't think too much and put the details. Now this is one very important thing. First of all, we have to be extremely careful when we do this, and we have to look at something here, especially look at the website address, whether it is the same banking address, because the domain has to be same. Domain, if they are having something else, because we generally don't look at that. That is another biggest challenge, because we tend to think that the email whatever has sent is the right email. It may not really be. And third most important thing is, you are trying to do any transaction. For example, in WhatsApp, in Facebook, many people are trying to sell you something, and they ask you to make a payment. Now you wanted the product, you started making a payment. See, one of the most important thing is, what you can see here, there is HTTPS. Now until unless there is no S, S is for secured. So if you are making any banking transaction, please ensure that there is an S there. HTTPS has to be there. If it is not there, there are higher chances that this could be a fraudulent thing, or secondly, it could be not secured. If it is not secured, somebody may be able to hack. So that is very important for you to know. Third thing, never ever go and try to surf in a open network area. Like for example, there is some free internet is available. You try to go there and try to surf. There is a possibility that there is a hacker who will try to hack your account because it may not be secure again. Another fourth most important thing is about the OTPs. See, now the biggest challenge with OTPs is everywhere everybody is telling you don't give OTPs. Now assume that your friend, your close friend, or your brother, sister, somebody says, give me OTP, we generally give. Look at the other way around. If they are saying it via their email, somewhere else they are saying, there is another challenge. You have to know many times there could be a possibility that their account is hacked. I had one of the instances one time where generally this is what happens. I was working in a network marketing company at one point of time, and my leader, I was chatting with him, and all of a sudden he said, I will show you how you can make 10,000 rupees every day. And so generally, obviously, when you are chatting with someone you know, you tend to believe, and this is a person whom you know. And he asked for the OTP, and immediately as I gave the OTP, my Google account, the entire account was I was not able to access my own account. Now he took over the entire access. Fortunately for me, there was no data which I had stored. Many people store their credit card details, they store their bank details. So what happens is there are chances that people will try to take away it. Then I called this person, and he said that my account is hacked. So there are possibilities like that to happen. Whenever you see that any such thing, first actually call these people, try to understand what has happened. Because generally nobody wants to get OTP, why they are asking for an OTP. So please try to do that. Fifth most important thing related to the OTP again is many shops, if you see, they have a system, especially in Paytm or other places. They give a separate account which is called a business Paytm account or a business Google Pay or business Phone Pay kind of an account where you give the OTP, then the amount gets debited. Now, what happens here is again they are requesting for the payment. Now, if by any chance, any time you give OTP, now what again happens here is it will not ask you again, it will directly debit. So these are all different ways in which people are making frauds, and most of the cases it is always we are trying to not take too much care about ourselves and try to give this. And one of the last thing which I am actually aware is about another very popular method. What they are trying to do is they are saying that there is some issue with your account or something, or some particular issue where they say that you download a software like AnyDesk, or there are many other tools very similar to AnyDesk. AnyDesk is actually a tool which through which you can give access to someone. This is popularly used by your hardware people, because suppose hardware or software guys, now what happens is they are remotely available and they want to give you service. Now they have to install some software or something. Now what they do is they can sit at any place and they can take control of your system, and they can probably help you to install a software. Now, what happens in this? Now, this is like where you are giving in remote control. This is very popularly nowadays used and rather misused. It's a very popular software and it's a very good software. Software is nothing to do with this. Now what happens in this is you are actually personally giving control to someone. Now people are asking you to download this and asking you to give control. Now once you have given the control, now they could install some app or some code inside your system, inside your phone, and they may be able to hack the system. So they will know everything whatever is there in your system and they may be able to hack. So please ensure that you don't give any such access until unless it is really necessary or you know the person whom you are giving this access to. Because there is no reason for you to give access. Understand, now it is like you are only doing whatever it is required to be done because you would have given the complete control to the other person. So these are some of the very popular ways in which people are trying to fraud you. I hope I have given you the information which requires you and prevents you from ensuring that you don't get into any such frauds. This is Sriharsha signing off. I am a digital marketing consultant and coach. I take companies from zero to $1 million. I also help companies to companies who are in offline business to grow online. And I have been doing this from the last 15 years and we have served more than 200 clients in more than 8 countries. Now, if you have been watching this video on YouTube, please go ahead and click on the subscribe button and the bell icon so that you keep getting notification about all the new videos whichever I'll be uploading. And if you're watching this on Telegram or on WhatsApp, please click on the join group button and you please join my group so that I will keep updating you with all these videos. And if you have liked this, please, please, please share this to as many people as possible, whomever you know, all the groups you have subscribed to on Telegram, on WhatsApp, on Facebook, on Twitter, everywhere. Please share this to as many people as possible. That will motivate me to make more such videos. Thank you very much. Have a great day.